Good day, folks. We have had the pleasure of watching the progress of four widower chicks over the past 42 days, from start of incubation. Today is their big bling day. They will be ringed like their doting mother named Wonder. The chicks have affectionately been nicknamed Hoochies by awesome Patreon supporter and supermod Peter. The chicks must be removed from the nest box to be banded, weighed and measured. Despite the nest being about 4 meters up in a tree, it is lower than our live feeder. Please see the link to our live feeder in the description below. As we go down the garden steps to the tree, a male hoopoe, possibly daddy, is sitting on the outside and calls the alarm and scatters. The chicks cower with only a few muffled peeps. This nest box has two levels, and three of the chicks are currently below and one in the top level. The bottom level has a hinged access door. Access to the top level can only be done by removing the roof, so it would be much easier if all chicks are on the bottom level.
Come on.
A soft brush does not provide any motivation for the chick to move to the bottom. Looks like the roof will have to be removed. The three chicks at the bottom will be removed first, and then the roof will be removed for the last chick. Entrance holes are closed just in case the chicks are startled. Each chick will be placed in a separate soft cloth bag, which can be securely closed. That's three chicks out, one to go. Now to open the roof to get to number four. Removing cladding and a few screws. All four chicks out and ready to be ringed. We are privileged to have bird ringer Ari Klopper here, who is a member of BirdLife North Gauteng, to band the chicks. Ari Klopper and his wife Ronelle have everything in place to do the weighing, measuring and banding as quickly as possible.
I started off by weighing each bird. Okay. Just zero it with the bag. And you just take it out of the bag and put the bag back in there. What's left is like the
woodaboo chicks have a very strong smell. The hoopoe parents and family are searching for their little ones. We will get them back to the nest as quick as possible.
I've got the weight, I've just measured the tarsus width, get an idea of the thickness of wing And the clearly it still needs to grow a bit. And we'll be more than generous in terms of the size of the ring I put on. Okay, so it is 5A. And 259 30. There is some that's ringed on the left foot that is flying around here. Those are the ones that I ring as juveniles.
Okay.
Otherwise, I usually ring on the right foot.
That is males and females.
Yeah. So I always ring on the right foot. It's something that I ring as a juvenile. It's just a way of when I see them, then I know which ring this is juvenile. Okay, so now the ring is nice and secure. There's no gap there. Can't fall off anything. And we're just going to take a couple of measurements. An important one would be wing length, which is still quite short. 108. Long trail. 92. And it is also the biggest short trail. 48.4 and 28.4. In the classes. And usually we check malt as well. Obviously, I'm not going to write anything again now because then we just write them all. They're probably all fours or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just that one.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. We're done with those. You can smell them.
The box is actually a lot worse than previously.
You might be able to tell the different sexes apart in terms of weight, but because they hatch on different days, they say that when they leave the nest, which is going to be the end of this week, you should be able to. And so this one's considerable heavier. This is 70.1. This one is almost 10 grams heavier than the other one. Let's see what. Okay, so that will just be the next number, 31. This males is strong.
And they have amazingly large pools, so here so young.
No, okay. The next time they're out of here, they'll be ready for the world.
They make up with everything, for everything they make up with attitude.
That's got lots of value.
That's what for sure. Yes.
97. Sure. So this one is definitely a little bit bigger than the other one. 50.6. But this might, we'll see once we've done all of them, who's the oldest. And
yeah.
34.4 25.6. Really looks like a stinker. Yeah. I don't know what I Amazing fish.
It is 85.
Oh, that's the first to go. Huh? So looks younger, but it's also heavy. 68.8, but he definitely looks smaller than any of the previous two. So usually measure the width of the tarsus, then you add a minimum of 3 millimeters to that, to select your wing, just to make sure there's enough space. But now I'm much more generous. I mean, this was 4.5, but I'm putting out 6 mils just because that is the standard ring for them. I have ringed some females with 5.25, but I'm erring inside of caution, as I said. They won't fall off. No, this one's got hardly any tail. Wing is 91. This, I think, is one of the younger ones, but definitely a male. 62.
Yeah, the very young one has still got some of those fluff stuff sticking out of the head.
One of the babies. So usually you would, obviously when you're done with this, you just hold, open your hand and the bird can go.
Yes.
You don't put them back in the
bag. No, right.
This is not usually. And this is also, that was definitely the youngest thing that we noticed.
Okay.
So you've been doing quite well for being the youngest.
Mm.
Almost. Why is that not zero? Just over to 70. Based on this, seems like three males and a female. and wait if we can use it at this stage. But.
Okay. The surprising is that they start incubating immediately after laying the first egg. It's not, you know, a lot of first lay all the eggs. And
they're always going to have these sort of different ages.
Yes.
That's why I'm always worried about the youngest ones. They have to fight 4-day-old brothers and sisters.
He's doing well.
Yeah, he's doing well. And he's one of the other ones. The first one who didn't look the youngest, but by any chance, much fighting. I am surprised that not one of them has swelled the whole place. 47.6.
Yeah, they've been very calm.
I read somewhere that when they're moving from the nest, they release a lot of fluids. Smelly fluids. 26.9. Not the oldest. That's it. We're done.
Can't put in the ring.
Wonder was back at the nest soon after our rude intrusion. She was very hesitant to enter the box, and she called for reinforcements from Dad and the rest of the family. Food supplies were soon flowing, and it was not long before they were a typically festive, happy hoopoe family again.